I'm upside down. I don't know what way, whether I'm coming or going. And my family, one part of my family, they live in Stockton-on-Tees. And they were worrying about me like, I don't know what, because if anything happens, it's always me it happens to, you know. Talk about the luck of the Irish. I don't know where they were when I was born.
I was well boosted because we were preparing for our St. Patrick's Day on Trafalgar Square. We were going to sing there. And at the last rehearsal, the virus took over and it was locked down.
On the 23rd of March, on my 80th birthday, they locked me up. And I was sitting there and my daughters had to come here. And I couldn't even go, I couldn't go near them. And I thought to myself, is this it? Is this what I've got to do now? You know me, I'm 80, I'm active. So why do I have to stay indoors all this time?
Yes, I picked up the coronavirus in about the third week of March and was really ill, was struggling for breath, would not go to the hospital, but my granddaughter lived nearby and she came and helped me through it.
Every day I was in the Irish Centre and to me it seemed terrible. I help people, I'm a volunteer, and it was just, I was getting more depressed because I couldn't get out and I knew people needed help and I couldn't help them, but I had to depend on other people to help me.
When lockdown hit, I missed my family most of all because I used to babysit my grandchildren. One of my sons lives in Surrey and we used to come and go from there, just hop on a train, say we're coming, and you know, we took all that for granted. And then lockdown hit and of course we had to stop all that. It was so hard not being able to see the grandchildren.
Well, we happened to close the day before Paddy's Day, which was a big decision for us. And then we got the news 3 days later that every pub had to close.
My name is Patrick Gormley. I'm originally from Belfast in Northern Ireland. I came to London in 1976 and I'm 70 this year. I don't think feel like it.
So we decided we'll enjoy it, and I said to all of my family to enjoy it and not to start worrying, because worrying won't get you anywhere.
Hello, my name is Michael O'Connor, or Mick O'Connor, but don't take the Mick, please. And my Irish connection is my parents. My mother was from Tralee in County Kerry and my father from Ballinlough in County Roscommon.
It was good, yeah, we kept up the music, we did, and the parties, and there was birthday parties here even, 3 birthday parties in this garden here, and we had good crowds.
On the 16th of March, I saw my mum for the last time. I went to visit her in her home, which is in Kentish Town. A week later, her home went into lockdown. I never saw my mum again. That was the last time I saw her. So I missed her birthday, I missed her Mother's Day, I missed her dying, and I missed her death. We can stop off in front of your house. And I went, oh, that would be wonderful. And so then that was like a switch went on and suddenly a whole thing went into motion. 8:30 in the morning. And as far as I'm concerned, it was a really, really happy and beautiful event. And I don't feel there's any need to have a funeral anymore because she had one and it was beautiful.
We lost a very dear friend, Alice Kennedy, who was really knew her for a long time, and it was a big and sad loss, and it just shows what the virus could do.
never realised how vulnerable older people were until this happened.
Going through the lockdown and what it has prepared us for, I think of Ireland. And in that first thoughts of Ireland when I heard the news about the virus, I just wanted to get on a plane. I just wanted to go home. I just wanted to walk with Dervil Galdove down Dollymount Strand. And then also the literature and the kind of great kind of culture of our country, I started to think about that.
Yes, when this is all over, this virus, my plan is to go back home to Ireland for security reasons and family all around me. I have 6 sisters and 4 brothers, and they all have their families and their grandchildren and now the great-grandchildren. So I would be in heaven.
When you think of the industry that we're in, the amount of people that are out of work, and I'm talking about not just musicians and singers, but sound engineers and roadies and lighting crew and everything else, it's a serious situation. But we have to keep going, and there will be light at the end of the tunnel, hopefully, for everybody.
I had the vaccine. The last time you talked to me, I had a dark blue navy on. Look at me now. I'm as bright as the sun itself, only if it only come out. Now, I go shopping for my daughter because they're isolating. And it's the other way around now. But people looking after me, now I'm looking after them, which I did in the past, and I'll keep doing it. And I will not give up. Now I'm fighting fit, thank God.